Hi, we're at a house in Bellflower, California, where we needed some duct to be replaced. We came out here a couple days ago and spoke with one of my friends, and he said that during the remodel, they needed to change some duct. When we got here, we realized that ductwork was asbestos and needed to be removed. So we brought out the abatement team almost instantly. They were here the following day to tear the stuff out. And then we're here the day after that to do our install. This was a really quick turnaround project. Everything kind of worked out. We had another job cancel, and so we were able to do that. But let's take a look inside and we'll show you what we're working on. So what we've done in here, half the house is under construction, and you'll see as you look up here, you've got some new framing, some new studs, and the other half of the house, you've got this really nice wood ceiling here, that's all staying. So as we're installing our duct, we're doing both connecting to existing cans, and we're also cutting in some new cans for the new construction stuff. Here's an example of a existing can. This thing's gonna get finished up nice and sealed up, but we'll have registers on that whole opening in the wall. Little side note, if you do have cans that are on the wall in your house, that's why you can't rip them out so easily. They're drywalled all the way around that sheet metal box. So we have to leave that in there. We're gonna connect the new grills to the existing can. The duct upstairs is all brand new. We'll show you that in a second. But right now, while we're here, let's check out the furnace in the closet. I'm gonna turn my flashlight on for you guys. We've got a nice large furnace, and everything was pretty well sealed up, but this really isn't something that we are working on today. This is a product of somebody else's install. That our job is to make sure that every ounce of airflow that this thing produces, we have calculated, assigned a numerical value to it, and we're gonna make sure that we deliver enough airflow so that this thing is never starved for air. We can squeeze every bit of efficiency out of this old furnace as possible. We're gonna continue into the hallway, up into the attic. I'm gonna show you the plenum where all the ducts are connected. Okay, back there we have the plenum where all the ducts are joined together. We've got our guys with their headlamps, tying in all the collars, sealing everything up, making sure it's all set and ready to go so we can attach all the pieces of ductwork to it. They're gonna strap them up, and they're gonna come down, and if I can move out of the way here, they're gonna attach to pieces like this, where this is a piece of duct that's hooked up to that can that I was showing you earlier. It's all gonna get changed out really well. Now, with this new duct system installed, we're gonna make sure that there are no air leaks, so which means we're not losing any energy or efficiency into places it doesn't need to be. Whenever you leak air out, you're bringing unconditioned, nasty air in, and it's wasting electricity. So we're not gonna waste energy anymore. Those ducts are gonna be insulated to high levels. The airflow for the system is going to be on point for exactly what it should be. And we have designed a duct system to operate at a half inch of static pressure, which is industry standard. And we will make sure that we get every ounce of efficiency out of the existing equipment as humanly possible.